So, we know our pronouns. And if I write down here, Kitabu, maybe I can even write down Al-Kitabu, and then now I'm joining it with pronoun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? So, his book, or book of his, how will you say? Kitabuhu. And now we know our 14 pronouns, so we can quickly say them. Kitabuhu, Kitabuhuma, Kitabuhum, Kitabuha, Kitabuhuma, Kitabuhum, Kitabuka, Kitabukuma, Kitabukum, Kitabuki, Kitabukuma, Kitabukunna, Kitabi, Kitabuna. Everybody must participate. Brother, the more you will say, the understanding will become stronger and you will be able to think quickly. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if I say, Fi kitabi he, I won't say Fi kitabi hu. No, who became he? Why? Fi kitabi he. See, here is your first, jarun wa majrur. And then, what is our next compound? Okay. Fi harf jar, kitabi isam majrur, wa huwa mudaf, and he mudaf ilayh. But try to say fi kitabi hu. Say everybody fi kitabi hu. How do you? It doesn't sound good. You have to use so many muscles of your mouth to say fi kitabi hu. So who became he? Not for any grammar reason, but just for phonetic reasons, brother. Are you with me? So you will be able to conjugate that also. Fi kitabi hima, fi kitabi him, fi kitabi ha, fi kitabi hima, fi kitabi hinna. Those five pronouns in the third person, huwa, huma, hum, huma, hunna, they will have a kasra. If there is a kasra before them, or if there is a ya before them with a sukun, fine. Are you with me, brother? And then fi kitabi ka, fi kitabi kuma, fi kitabi kum, fi kitabi ki, fi kitabi kuma, fi kitabi kunna, fi kitabi, and then fi kitabina, fi kitabina, bina. Okay. Now, brothers and sisters, same thing will happen. Even we say, because this comes all the time in the Quran. What will you say now? RaBBuHu, RaBBuHuma, RaBBuHum, RaBBuHa, RaBBuHumaa, RaBBuHunna, RaBBuKa, RaBBuKumaa, RaBBuKum, RaBBuKi, RaBBuKumaa, RaBBuKunna, RaBBi, and then RaBBuNa. And we say all the time in the Quran. Now let us use min. Min RaBBihi, min RaBBihima, min RaBBihim, min RaBBiha, min RaBBihima, min RaBBihinna, min RaBBika, min RaBBikuma, min RaBBikum, min RaBBiki, min RaBBikuma, min RaBBikunna, min RaBBi, min RaBBina. So you see, it's very easy, logical, and fascinating. I found this whole thing very beautiful and fascinating. Okay? So we have an idea. Now, if the pronoun joins preposition. What is the result? Charun wa majrur. Are you with me? If the pronoun joins preposition, it becomes jarun wa majrurun. So here I am writing, brothers and sisters. How many? There are on page number, I think 17. These are the hafjars given, brother. Min, I think, ala. I'm not writing in order, ila. And then we have fi. And then we have bi. And then we have an. Min, ala, ila, fi, bi, an. Li, very important, li. Is there any more? That's it. Now, if you say min, and you use no pronoun, again, brothers and sisters. Okay. Now you use the pronoun again. Okay. min. Very easy, very simple. Once you get into that, momento, it becomes extremely easy, brother. It will become extremely easy. What is it, brother? Start from min. Minhu, minhuma, minhum, minha, minhuma, minhunna, minka, minkuma, minkum, minki, minkuma, minkunna, minni, minna. And if I say anything, brother, you will be able to do it. Just for the sake of fun. This is what we'll do in book 2, but I'm doing it now. Because it is in the Quran. For the sake of fun. If I, see, you started it. Can you do 14? I bet you can do it. Ready? Innahu, innahuma, innahum, innaha, innahuma, innahunna, innaka, innakuma, innakum, innaki, innakuma, innakunna, inni, innana. You can say both ways. Innani you can say, or you can say inni, or you can say inna, or you can say innana. Both will be correct. Both will be correct. How easily you said it, brother.
How would you write inni?
Okay. You can write down two ways. Innani, or you will say inni. Or you will say innana, or you will say inna. Ji? Ji?
Inna is more used, right?
Yeah, inna is more. But both are correct. Both are correct. Yeah. Are you with me? So, did you see how much ease you were able to say it? Yes. Oh, don't ask me that. That is book 2, brother. We are only trying to conjugate. Didn't I tell you about that student who had come from some madrasa in India, and he had worked very hard. He was a brilliant student. When he went to the Middle East to study more, and he always used to say, I know grammar very well, I can conjugate anything, So the teacher gave him some word, he wrote it down something. And, because as we wrote down this, I can write down anything and you will be able to conjugate. Are you with me there? Let me write down. What will this be now? Annahu, annahuma, annahum, annaha, annahuma, annahunna, annaka. See, now I'm using anna, all the annaka, annakuma, annakum, annaki, annakuma, Anna kunna, anni, anna. Now come to lakin. Lakinnahu, lakinnahuma, lakinnahum, lakinnaha, lakinnahuma, lakinnahunna, lakinnaka, lakinnakuma, lakinnakum, lakinnaki, lakinnakuma, lakinnakunna, lakinnani, lakinnana. Pardon? Did you have any difficulty in doing it, sisters? Inshallah, no difficulty. So, you know, these are the things which will make it very easy now. And whenever you will see these combinations, your mind will immediately understand in a fraction of a second. Okay? Now, do not do anything with inna. Just forget it that you don't know it. Otherwise, you will get into trouble. Because it is a different ball game. Which we will do in book 2, inshallah, very soon. We hope to finish book 1 by the end of the month, inshallah. And then beginning of December, we will start book 2, inshallah. But I won't go fast. If there is need for revision, I will revise. You will tell me, and I will revise again. Are you with me, brother? Now, that student, let me finish the story. So the teacher wrote down a word and said, conjugate, and he conjugated everything. He said, what is the meaning of this word? He said, I don't know. You don't know and you conjugate it? Yes, I can conjugate anything. He said, brother, this word does not exist in Arabic language. You conjugated something that does not exist in Arabic language. He said, how do I know? To me it looked like a verb, so I conjugate it. So you will become so strong, you know, you will conjugate anything. Because the rules are there in your mind, how it works, you know. So inshallah you will find that when we go to book 3, which is such a thick book, but it is most beautiful book of the 3 books. Because your foundation is there. Your foundation is there, you will find it most interesting, inshallah. Okay, fine. Now we come to Allah. Now, what is the difference between Allah and Min? The difference is that Allah ends with a Ya. It's a Ya. Even though it is Alif, it is a Ya. And then sisters, Allah. What will be Allah? Will become, you put who to it? Alayhi. Why did you make it He? Phonetic reason, but why? Because Ya came with a sukun. So if there is a kasra before the pronoun who, huma, hum, huma, hunna, or Ya before who, huma, hum, huma, hunna, then the who will become he, huma will become hima, hum will become him, huma will become hima, and hunna will become hinna. Are you with me? Are you with me? Inshallah. So brother, start now. Alay he, alay hima, alay him, alay alay ha. No change. Alay hima, alay hinna. And then alayka, alaykuma, alaykum, alayki, alaykuma, alaykunna, and then alayya. Because 2 ya came, now we have to give a fatha. I explained to you the other day. Alayya. And then alayna. Let us do quickly. Ila. Ilaihi, ilaihima, ilaihim, ilaiha, ilaihima, ilaihinna, ilaika, ilaikuma, ilaikum, ilaiki, ilaikuma, ilaikunna, ilaiya, ilaina. Got the idea, brother? Fi. Fihi, fihima, fihim, fiha, fihima, fihinna, fika, fikuma, fikum, fiki, fikuma, fikunna, fiya, fina. Got the idea, brother? Next one, B. Bihi, bihima, bihim. Bi, biha, bihima, bihinna, bika, bikuma, bikum, biki, bikuma, bikunna, bi, bina. MashaAllah. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? An, anhu, and Huma and Hum and Ha and Huma and Hunna Anka Ankuma Ankum Anki Ankuma Ankunna Anni Anna. Very good. Now comes Li. Ready? Lihu? No. Lahu. Lahu. Li will become Lahu. Got the idea? Now, mothers and sisters, you got to write it. You got to write this at home, then inshallah, you will never ever forget it. Everything, even in the handout, we have done for you, but you have to write it on a separate page. All of these things, writing will make you strong. Lahu, lahuma, lahum, laha, lahuma, lahunna, laka, lakuma, lakum, laki, lakuma, lakunna, li, lana. MashaAllah. It's not given in the book. We have given you separate handout in order to make you strong, so that when you come to the lessons become halwa puri. The lessons become halwa puri. Are you with me? Becomes very easy. Becomes delicious, brother. Okay? Like delicio. Okay? Are you with me, brother? I felt when I was studying that doing these things, you know, when you have an idea, you know what it means, you know it's jar majrur, things become very easy, brother. Very, very easy for you. Okay? Now we come to zarf. There are many zarf. But these are the most common and popular. Ma'a, ma'ahu, ma'ahuma, ma'ahum, ma'aha, ma'ahuma, ma'ahumma, ma'ahunna, ma'aka, ma'akuma, ma'akum, ma'aki, ma'akuma, ma'akunna, ma'i, and then ma'ana. See? And you know, it can come with tahta and fauka and everything. Same, yes, brother. Ma'i. Because, see, here is ma'a. Come, our favorite, ya mutakallim. What will it do, brother Farooq? It will bring it down. It doesn't like fatha. So, ma'a became ma'i. And I always say, remember, how many words are there? Two. Ma'a plus ya. And if I say, how many words are here? Two. Well, one is harf jar, and then other is ism majroor. Harf jar and ism majroor. That ya is majroor now. And if I write down, brother Li, how many words are there? There are two words. One is harf jar, and what is this? That is why I tell you, harfjar, you got to say loudly, brother. Harfjar is a majrur. Anytime you hear me looking at you and say harfjar, I need an answer. Is a majrur, you know, so that you will never ever forget. And when the ism is majrur, you will give it a kasra. You will not give it a dhamma. You will never make a mistake then. No, any. Harf jar is a majroor. Ya mutakallim, it will bring it down. This is what I meant. See, ma'i came. But if I say lahu, brother, what is lahu? Jarun wa majroor. So where is harf jar? Where is isam majroor? So if I tell you harf jar, isam majroor. Every time there is a harf jar, the noun will be majroor with a kasra. Now there is no kasra here. Why? Because it is mabni. Because it is fixed. It is fixed. That is why. Okay? Now we come to inda. Ready? Indahu, indahuma, indahum, indaha, indahuma, indahunna, indaka, indakuma, indakum, indaki. Indakuma, indakunna, indi, indana. Indana. Okay. Now if I say min, what will happen now? Let me write down, brother. Indahu. Now I want to write down min here. What will happen now? Min in the, now the came, he will come. Why did you put he? Because there is a kasra there. Are you with me? See. Remember, in this is a noun. In the zarf, adverb is a noun. So what is this? Min in the jarun or majrun. And what is this? Zarf and mudafilay. What will you call it? Zarf and mudafilay. See? Very logical. Jarun, majrurun, and the next compound is zarf and mudafilay, inshallah. So this is total revision, brother, from yesterday. And you wrote the Quranic verses. Write down again. And now you think about lakum dinukum wali dini. Actually it is dini, but ya mutakalam is dropped. Style of the Quran. Are you with me? And then fi kulubihim maradun ala absarihim gishawatun wallahum azabun azimun. So what is lahum? Jarun or majrurun. And again I told you yesterday, brothers and sisters, this is a golden rule to remember. Jarun or majrurun and zarf with mudaf ilayhi, they can never ever be mubtada. You have to remember this golden rule. They can never be mubtada. But you don't have to write it, brother. You got to just remember it now. Kya kaha maine? Ke jar majroor, which is shibbu jumla, and zarf with mudaf ilayhi, that is another shibbu jumla, they will never ever be mubtada. They can become khabar. So if they start the sentence, you do not have to be gabrified and say, it came in the beginning, so min is mubtada. No, brother. It is jar majroor. Inshallah, you will remember this. Okay, brothers and sisters. Enough of revision? Alhamdulillah.